Thank you for downloading from the BBC. For details of our complete range of podcasts and our terms of use, go to bbcworldservice.com/podcasts.
You're listening to the BBC World Service. I'm Emre Azizlerli, and this is the Pink Certificate. Late on a Sunday night, Istanbul's main bus terminal is teeming with people. Emotions are running high. But this is no ordinary night with ordinary farewells. Tonight, young men are being seen off by their families to go and start their military service, which is compulsory for men in Turkey. And it is not taken lightly.
So as the young conscript is now being thrown into the air, just a few meters away from me, his friends were shouting, "En büyük asker bizim asker." Our soldier is the greatest soldier. This is something that everybody has to do. And in most cases, especially in traditional families, this is the first time that the son is leaving the family. And he's going to go and do his duty for his country. And Turkey is a very patriotic nation. This is a proud moment for the family as well. And at the same time, there are certain dangers, actually, because there's still some fighting going on in eastern Turkey. And if one of these young men are conscripted in the barracks there, they might find themselves in real combat. But overall, what we see here now is celebrating the moment, because they are taking a huge step into manhood.
Sen söyleyeyim sana ya.
Askere gidiyor musun?
Ben 4 senem var abi Allah izin verirse. Az kaldı be.
So we have a gentleman here who says he has 4 more years before he does his military service. Are you abi looking forward ben. To it?
Abi gitmek istemez miyim ya? Tabii gideceğim. Vatani görevim yapacağım tabii ya.
He says of course he's looking forward to it. It's his duty
askere
for his country.
Askere gitmeyen adam mı denilir abi ya? Sen de öyle bir söylüyorsun ki.
He is saying you cannot anlatsın call a man who doesn't go to the army.
But actually, not all men go through military service. Some are excluded. Even though homosexuality is legal in Turkey, the army bans it. Gay men are given an exemption, commonly known as the Pink Certificate. But the generals want to be convinced that only homosexuals are exempt from what may take up to 15 months in the barracks. So, if you're gay, you're asked to prove it.
I just got off the ferry and I'm on the Asian side of Istanbul now in Kadıköy, and I'm waiting for someone whom I shall call Gökhan. That's not his real name. He wants to keep his identity secret. And really, I'm not quite sure where we will speak. He has some disturbing things to tell me, and I'm sure he would want somewhere a bit more private than this.
In fact, Gökhan is happy to talk to me in a cafe, but he's asked me to disguise his voice, so his words are going to be spoken by an actor.
Except my mother, everybody knows. My mother can't stand it. I am sure everybody knows that also here in Turkey, being a gay is also a problem.
Gökhan tells me he did give military service a shot in the late 90s, but after a week, he realized he'd have to get out. So he decided to admit to the army that he was gay. He'd heard that with photographic evidence that proved his homosexuality, they might allow him to leave.
These pictures are, pornographic pictures. Pictures taken while you are having sexual relation with your partner.
And how did you have the photographs taken?
It was terrible. Firstly, my friend's friend was my partner. My friend took the photos. And those times there were no digital photographing machines. You had to go to the you had to wash the photographs, negatives.
You had to have them developed.
Yes, yes. And I went to a photographing shop and said, "Army wanted these from me. So I am giving it to you. Just I trust you," I said. And then when I went to take my photos back from the photographing store, they said I looked at his eyes. He didn't have any eye contact with me. He just gave the photos, and I paid and went back.
So I suppose if it's going to be proof, your face must be visible.
Yes, yes, yes. It was terrible. It's still terrible. These photographs are with somebody now. Somebody holds these photographs. Anything may happen. He may show it on the television. He may show it at my village, at my city, my parents, where my parents live. Well, in fact, it is not a problem for me. It is just a punishment for my parents and for my relatives. They will not be able to look at the eyes of their friends.
This is my hometown, and I left 15 years ago. And before I left, I only heard of a few places, gay places, you know, with black doors, and you couldn't really see what was going on. Whereas in recent years, new establishments have opened up, and they are exclusively gay. They have a gay clientele, and they are also more transparent. They are not locked behind closed doors.
It is a good place to meet Ahmed, another gay man, who is trying to get exemption from military service. He came out during his initial call-up, and he was referred to a military hospital.
Our drinks have arrived, so can you tell me then, what sort of evidence did they require for the diagnosis?
Birçok saçma sorular sordular. Sorular arasında...
They asked lots of absurd questions. Questions about my sex life. When had I first had anal intercourse? When had I had oral sex for the first time? They asked me what sort of toys I'd played with as a child, whether I liked football or not, whether I dressed up as a woman or used woman's perfume, whether I put on makeup. I hadn't shaved for a few days, and they commented on the way I looked, saying that I didn't look like a normal gay man.
So when you appeared in front of them, you think that they were surprised that you did not look exactly like a gay man, like the stereotype of a gay man, if I should say so. And they didn't believe you. Sana inanmadılar mı?
Bence bana inanmadılar. Şaşırdılar. Onun dışında...
I don't think they believed me. They asked me to give them a photograph of me dressed in woman's clothes, together with other transvestites. But I told them I'm not a woman. I don't feel like a woman, or act like a woman, or dress like a woman. So instead I offered to bring them a picture of me kissing another man. They agreed to that. So that's what I did. But to be honest, I didn't feel good about it.
But people in Turkey, they are all doing their national service, most of them, and they come from very different walks of life. What is it which is so different about you that it would psychologically affect you so much?
Belirli bir sistem içerisinde yer almak istemiyorum. Kurallar...
I don't want to be in such a system. The rules of the army contradict my whole philosophy and way of life. I don't believe that I owe it to this country to go through military service. I don't think anybody should be under such an obligation. They shouldn't try and diagnose who is gay and who has a psychosexual disorder. At the end of the day, we are human too. But gay men are not treated as human beings. This is damaging.
It seems there is no one system of issuing the pink certificate. Nowadays, when a man declares that he's gay, he appears in front of military doctors, and their approach seems to vary. When Yağmur came out, they handed him a piece of paper and some crayons and asked him to draw a picture.
What is that there?
Man.
Oh, that's the
Çünkü
man.
Çünkü bir ağaç, bir ev, bir insan.
A tree, a person and a house. Mm-hmm. Did you draw this exact picture there as well? Aynısını mı çizdin orada?
Evet, aynısı.
The house and the tree, they are on one side of the page, and then a bit away from them there is one person at the edge of a cliff.
Heteroseksüel olan bir kişi de aynı resmi çizsin. Hiçbir fark olmazdı.
You're sure of one thing, a heterosexual could have drawn this same exact picture. Muafiyet belgeni aldın mı? Did you get your exemption?
Yes, aldım.
Yes, you did. You had to go to the military hospital. Askeri hastaneye
evet,
mi gittin?
Evet.
Yes. How did you appear? Nasıl görünüyordun?
Çok feminen.
Effeminate. What were you wearing? Neler giymiştin üzerine?
Üzerimde çok kısa bir coat short ve atlet.
Shorts and a tank top.
Çok hafif makyaj.
And a light makeup.
Bu şekilde giyinmediğim takdirde benim için zor olacaktı raporumu almam.
Çünkü if you had not dressed up as such, then it would be far more difficult for you to get your exemption.
But not all gay men in Turkey want to avoid military service.
I think probably this is the most famous military song.
Yes, this is definitely the most famous one about army life, no? Here is the singer talking about the young conscript far away from home, and his mother, his father, his sister, they're all missing him. Very sad. Did you listen to the song when you were in the barracks?
Every night I would be singing to this song. Everyone knows this song, and when you go at night to the barracks, after everything is over, you would definitely hear someone playing this song, and you would definitely see someone in tears.
And would you also be in tears at
Not
all?
Not really, no. I mean, I would put on my Barbra Streisand.
So you introduced a lot of young Turkish men to Barbra Streisand.
Yeah, and Liza Minnelli.
You don't want to give us your name, though, do you?
No, I don't.
Why?
Because I'm not out to my family, and Turkey is still a very homophobic society, and my work connections, so I'd rather not say my name.
But you did go to the military, and you made friendships there.
I did. I did a lot of friendships. One of my longest relationships was in the military.
When you say a relationship, you mean a romantic one?
Yes, my boyfriend. I mean, we met in the military, and for 6 months we were together.
And how did you manage that relationship?
Well, military is a very homoerotic environment, actually. You have all these young men, hormones raging, and you stick them into the same place. Hundreds of them sleep together in the same room. So basically, there's so much touching. And you would see soldiers holding hands, sleeping next to one another. But you wouldn't consider it gay. So when I was holding hands with my boyfriend, nobody presumed anything out of the ordinary, actually.
Have you met any one of these guys later in life and you told them, as a matter of fact, I'm a gay man?
The thing is, aside from my boyfriend, I had sex with other soldiers. But they didn't think that they were gay. I mean, it would go as far as having sex, but they don't think themselves as gay, as long as they are tough, for example.
Or as long as they are the active partner,
or there is no intercourse. They are just fooling around with a friend from their point of view, and they are not gay. So some of them knew that I had sex with 5 guys, but didn't think I was gay. I was just adventurous.
For you, on the whole, it has been a positive experience, you say. What sort of skills have you picked up there?
I would give lessons to younger soldiers every night. I would teach them basic stuff, but some of them I taught how to read and write. Some of these young Kurdish boys, I taught them Turkish. And after some point, I started teaching them about, for example, safe sex, why they should be using condoms when they're going to the brothel.
They were going to the brothel?
Yeah, every Sunday, to be honest.
Did they invite you as well?
They did.
And what was your excuse?
My fiancé wouldn't allow it.
Turkish Airlines, flight 201, 7A to Ankara. Enjoy the departure gate number 1.